Bob Eugen, I feel badly because I think that's something that could have been won. That's a race that could have been won. And John Faso, those are some of the people that, you know, decided for their own reason not to embrace whether it's me or what we stand for, but what we stand for meant a lot to most people.
They're the president the day after the election, rubbing it in, if you will, and piling on Republicans who lost. The president also left a whole lot of Republicans hanging out to dry after he convinced many of them to support the Obamacare repeal. Then he said the House bill to do just that was, in his words, mean. John Faso, one of the Republicans who stuck his neck out, voted for the Obamacare repeal, and he joins us now. I'd be remiss if, given the last few days, I didn't ask you about former President Bush. In fact, we showed a photo of you and your son 20 years ago, I believe up in the main compound with the late president. A lot of great things have been said about him as both a statesman and basically a public servant. Give a little context to the photo we see with the president and your son.
Sure. That actually, it was 30 years ago,
30 years,
astonishingly. 30 years ago, my wife and I, in 1987, just happened to be in Kennebunkport, and we had gotten away for a few days with our then our only child, our son Nick, who was a little over 3 years old. And I happened to run into an aide to the vice president, who I knew from many years before. And he said, oh, are you coming out to the vice president's house tomorrow? And we said, well, we didn't know anything about it. We were just happened to be here in Kennebunkport. And he invited us out. And of course, the vice president was then looking to run for president in 1988. And he had a whole series of Iowa and New Hampshire political people at his house for a barbecue. And I was the lone New York State assemblyman there with my wife and son, and he and Barbara Bush were just delightful. They set my son on, all grandchildren played on. They took us through their house, and they were just delightful, wonderful people.
Looking back at the last 2 years, I'm curious from your expectations to what you ran into. What are you going to take away from Washington?
Well, number one, it's a great honor to serve, and I was very honored to have this opportunity for the last 2 years. I regret that I wasn't given an extension on my term by the voters, but that's the democratic process, and I respect it. What I take away from it is just a sense of respect of our Constitution and our democratic traditions in our country.
You know, you have an interesting perspective on this, having been in Albany. And now in Washington, forgive me for the loaded question, but which is more screwed up, Albany or Washington? You know certainly all the dysfunction jokes that are attached to the state capitol in New York, and certainly a lot those same also attached to Washington. Having seen both firsthand, which is worse?
I think that actually there's a much better transparency in Washington, surprisingly. And there's also much more actual debate and on the substance of things in Washington than there is in Albany. But, look, both have imperfections, to be sure. But I think that, be they Democrats or Republicans, most of the colleagues that I serve with here in Washington are truly trying to do what's best for the country and for their districts. That's been my experience. And I think that all too often we become very polarized in our country because people tend to listen and to watch and to read the things they already agree with. And I think that there aren't enough people who want to actually approach this job from a philosophical standpoint of saying, look, I have my principles and my beliefs, but I understand in our system we have to base it on compromise. And that's what our whole system is based on. I do foresee perhaps a more polarized Congress going forward, and I'm fearful that we're not going to be able to get things done because of that.
I think you're right. I know with this next one, you're probably going to take the high road knowing you, so I'll go there. But the president did you no favors. You very well maybe would have been going back to Washington if not for a couple notable pieces of legislation beyond the blue wave. First, the tax bill that certainly hit New York and a few other blue states in the wallet that I know you didn't support. But you were lobbied to get behind the repeal of Obamacare. And before the ink was even dry on what came out of the House, the president went out and called it a mean bill. You went to the mat for this, and then the day after the election, he calls you out by name. For a guy who prides himself on loyalty, he sure wasn't to you. And I know you stuck your neck out for a bill that you had your own qualms with, but you still did it. I got to only imagine that you probably don't feel that you were done right by this president.
I think that the president's remarks were unfortunate. I supported the health bill because the ACA is not living up to its promise to reduce premiums and deductibles. And it has, instead of being focused on the people who didn't have insurance, they changed the marketplace for everyone that had insurance. And I hear from people all the time that tell me, look, I have insurance, but I can't afford an $8,000 deductible. So what we were trying to do is to actually address the flaws of the ACA. I think it was very badly mishandled, obviously, and obviously we weren't successful.
And that brings me to my final question. We talked about public service of the now late president. You've dedicated a lot of your adult life to it as well. Is this it for you, or would you want to get back into the ring after, as we've seen, so much toxicity and so much polarization that I think you rightfully so say probably is only going to get worse?
Well, I do think that I don't know what the future holds for me. I'm going to discuss that with my wife and family over Christmas. I'm looking forward to Christmas. But I all I can say is it's very important for public policy to move forward in a productive and way that is consistent with our constitutional and democratic traditions. And part of that means that you've got to work with people that you may not agree with to try to get things done for the public. And I think that's really the strength of our country. And if we just turn our backs on this process, if good people turn their backs, then we're not going to have a better outcome.
I wish you the best of the holidays. And again, I thank you for your service.
Thank you so much, Richard. Merry Christmas to everyone and happy holidays to you and your family as well.
And coming up next, earlier in the program, we spoke with Senator Bob Menendez about how this Congress could punish the Saudis over the killing of Washington Post columnist Jamal Khashoggi. Now, after the break, retired Rear Admiral Joe Sestak, he joins us to talk about the geopolitical, military, and diplomatic issues surrounding this.